All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, fly.
Hello, friends, and welcome to episode 17, the epic grand finale of Bottoms Up. This morning, we are still in Houston, Texas. We're going to head to Dallas in a few days. We are taking an entire cast field trip to a place I've never been called Schlitterbahn.
Schlitterbahn.
Apparently, it's an epic water park. And it is hot.
You do the Schlitterbahn.
Maggie, what's your theory on why it's called Schlitterbahn?
German for spinal injury.
Oh, that's probably, that's good. That's really good. What does Schlitterbahn mean,
Joel?
Well,
I'm looking it up.
Yeah?
It means terrifying hell.
No, it does not.
It means slip and slide.
The slip and slide. Slip and slide
Schlitterbahn.
Someone finally knows what Schlitterbahn means. And of course, it's this guy.
Hello.
Sean Watson knows what Schlitterbahn means. What's it mean?
Slippery road.
In what language, do you know?
German.
Slippery road.
So be careful when driving on the Schlitterbahns. Let's do this Schlitt.
Well, we gotta do the song.
You do the Schlitterbahn.
Lincoln, are you ready to Schlitterbahn? Yeah. Guys, this is the best one. Let's watch the next person go down. Oh my God.
Gotcha.
That is called Massive, and it's the largest water roller coaster in the world. What makes it a water roller coaster instead of just a slide? Well, it's all water powered, but not only on the way down, you also go up, and they have jets that propel you forward that are water power. That is their not-so-lazy river. You think it's lazy until you're thrown into rapids. It's pretty awesome. So Schlitterbahn is in Galveston, Texas, and down there is the Gulf of Mexico. How about that? There's the bay side, and there's the Gulf side. And there is Massive, the tallest water roller coaster in the world. And they're about to go on. These tiki statues are warming up. This one's like, oh, 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 oh. And that's Julianne on a hammock.
Nothing says Schlitterbahn like Frito pie. Frito pie is chili and cheese dumped in a bag of Fritos.
That's more like a walking Frito.
You might get a Schlitterbahn later tonight.
Oh yeah!
Surfing adventures here at the Schlitterbahn.
What? He just did a flip! Are you crazy? I don't know you, but you're fancy.
That's what you call a professional.
What?
Oh!
If I tried those tricks, I would lose my Schlitt.
This is the tale of a little bird named Schlitface. Schlitface lived at Schlitterbahn, and he would mooch all the food from the people. He would jump among their coolers, among their sunblock, among their cups, looking for the smallest of specks of food. Leftover French fries, leftover pretzels, a little bit of Frito pie, you say? But every now and then, when there was not any leftover food, he would jump right into their hat and see if there was any food on top of their clothing, until a big man with a camera from Broadway.com said, "Get away from their food! Get away from their food!"
Have a Schlitterific day!
Maggie and I have started the Houston mural. It's a work in progress, but so far, so good. I know there's not much to see yet, but it's the beginning.
Hey.
I want you guys to see the mug that Kyle and Beeman got me in action.
I think you will be my neighbor, Mr. Rogers. Yeah, let's just get some coffee. Mr. Rogers, you should change your sweater. What? What?
Big reveal! It is finished with the exception of everyone's signatures, so we'll let it dry during the matinee. Yay! Look what we did! It's mural signing time!
Yeah!
Yay!
How did you do this in 3 days? Or was it 3 days?
Yeah, we were here in the mornings before the shows. Maggie did most of it. But yay! Are you looking for a sign spot? We're gonna sign Kate. Nice!
That was terrible.
Nominees for Best Performance by an Actor in a Leading Role in a Musical.
Oh boy.
Christian Borle, falsetto.
Hey!
Josh Groban, the great.
Yeah!
Oh. Carl Groundhog Day.
Yeah. Hey!
David Hyde Pierce, hello, Dolly.
Woohoo!
So nervous!
Oh my God,
he's so nervous!
The award
goes to Ben Platt!
Hey!
Oh,
yes!
Oh, this is sweet!
Yes, Ben Platt!
And the Tony Award goes to Dear Evan Hansen.
Wow!
All right.
Congratulations, friends!
Yay!
Houston, we have a problem. And that problem is that I'm gonna spend most of this day in tears because we are at NASA. Yeah, I feel you, Alan Shepard. That is the front of a piece of a spaceship, and that's a popcorn machine. That is a new suit, and there's only one that exists right now, and it's in Marlin's lab because he is developing it. He is smarter than all of us combined. Whoa. On to Dallas. And away we go. What do you think about that, Nico?
Excited to go to Dallas?
When you don't have a car at Sonic, when you're traveling by bus with a large group of people, this is how you wait for your food. Jeff's like, get the camera away from me while I'm ordering my Sonic. Why, hello there, Dallas. Something rotten is coming for you. This chandelier descends out of the ceiling. How cool is that? Oh my God, that's so amazing. Take that, Phantom of the Opera. Well, we are open in Dallas. What a great crowd. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much. Since you guys are always there for all the glorious, wonderful moments, I thought I would share a not so wonderful one with you. Today, when I woke up and headed out for breakfast and I was walking around, I got super sick, like puke sick. And I wasn't sure I was going to be able to do it. And I started to do the show and I felt a little queasy again. As theater has a way of doing, the show takes over and you stop thinking about it, and with an audience as great as tonight's audience, thank you, you get through. So I got through and I'm feeling better now, and hopefully we'll continue to feel better, but goof, it's not always easy and fun. In fact, more often than not, it has its challenges. Tonight's audience got me through. Thank you, Dallas. I look forward to being here for the next 2 weeks. Woo! This is called Thanksgiving Hall, and it's in the middle of downtown Dallas. And apparently, when I go in here and look up, it's really cool. Maggie does awesome research of each place that we go to and finds all these cool things for us to do.
It's closed. We'll come back.
I realize that these are cattle, steers, Texas Longhorns to be exact, and not wildebeests. But it doesn't want to make me run through them like Simba any less.
The bacon's gonna be an upcharge.
Yeah, that's fine. And no onions at all. And fries, yeah.
What kind of cheese?
Well, it's midnight on June 15th, 2017, which means that it's my birthday, and I'm 35 years old. And I don't know how you guys plan to spend your 35th birthday, but the first thing I'm going to do in my 35th year is have a bowl of marshmallow Fruity Pebbles out of a Tor bowl, otherwise known as Tupperware. Happy birthday, dear me. Thanks, Fruity Pebbles. In honor of my 35th birthday, me, Maggie, Andrew, one of our wig supervisors, and Sean, our assistant carpenter, are at Zero Gravity Thrill Amusement Park, and I'm bringing you on all these rides.
Is this where we're starting today?
Yes, on the Sky Coaster. Of like glorious and painful. Maggie and I are about to have a lovely meal high above Dallas at something called the Reunion Tower. That's not it. That's it. Whoa, and way up there is a Wolfgang Puck restaurant. Well, Maggie and I are about to have a romantic candlelit dinner atop the Reunion Tower at Wolfgang Puck's, and you're not invited, but I will leave the camera on the edge of the table so you can look out the window and see our round trip around the top of Dallas. So that does it for Bottoms Up. Can you believe it? 17 episodes, 6 months we've spent together. I've loved every second of it. I hope you have too. First of all, I instead of doing rapid fire Twitter questions, I just wanted to spend some time thanking you guys. You guys have been such incredible fans, not only in your comments online, but at the stage door. I can't tell you, every single night I have people at the stage door saying how much they love the vlogs, how much they've, one fan called it virtually hanging out with us. I love that. I've loved virtually hanging out with you too. And please don't stop coming to say hi at the stage door. Trust me, I am going to explore your upcoming cities and have just as much fun, and I can't wait to meet you all at the stage door, you sweet, sweet people. Thanks for watching. I also just want to say, you know, the vlog is somewhat of an accurate representation. What it doesn't show you is the show. And the show is not only the greatest part of this tour, but it's also the hardest amount of work. You get to see us running around and going to theme parks and exploring the history and culture of each city as we go while maintaining an 8-show week. And that's no joke. Trust us, it's not all fun and games. There's hard work happening out here. I've got an amazing group of people here who hold me up every night. They're really the greatest people I can imagine doing this with. I also just want to say, travel. I know. Trust me, before I got to do this, I know how expensive and sort of like outlandish getting to just see the country is. But if you ever get a window, even if it's a weekend, go somewhere, drive. Go somewhere you've never been. Meet the people there. Eat their food. You know, it's like, I can't tell you how much it heals. It heals divides between people. People are kind everywhere. There's great food, great culture, great entertainment, great music, great souls, great people everywhere. You just need to go meet them. And maybe if they meet us and see our differences while we're out here being kind to them, they'll understand. I don't think there's another way to do it. So if you can, travel. I really think travel is the enemy of ignorance. I really do. I think it builds bridges. Enough of the soapbox. I also want to thank the people at Broadway.com, Paul Warren Torek, Ryan Lee Gilbert, my editor, Mark Hayes, the guy who did the graphics, Tony Mendoza, also a guy named Sachin Darwadkar, who I worked with on all of the editing and stuff. But I'm going to leave you with something that I personally edited and put together over the last 2 weeks. Although you could say I've been working on it for the last 6 months. But it's my way of sending us off on this beautiful adventure. So I hope you enjoy the next few minutes as you see me sort of celebrating my road family. And they are that. Everyone in the cast and crew on this show loves what they do. They love that you guys come to see it. And they truly are on a mission to make America laugh again. And we're succeeding. So come laugh with us. Thanks again so much. I hope you enjoy the next few minutes. And keep up with Broadway.com, because they've told me to hang on to this camera and keep filming some adventures. So you never know when Bottoms Up might pop back up on your menu. And keep up with Broadway.com, because they have told me to hang on to this camera. So you never know when you might be scrolling through Broadway.com and see an episode where you can catch up with Bottoms Up. And before we go, keep up with Broadway.com, because they've told me to hang on to this camera and keep on filming adventures, so you never know when Bottoms Up might be back on top. And before we go, Broadway.com has told me to hang on to this camera and continue to film adventures. So keep checking back in, because you never know when Bottom's gonna be back on top.